Welcome to Jena. Welcome to the Leibniz Institute of Photonic Technology, and welcome to our research department, Functional Interfaces. In our department, we research photoactive materials, photoactive interfaces for life science applications, applications in sensing and detection, and for solar energy conversion. For instance, we research the photophysics, the interaction of molecules and light in complex environments, for instance, of drugs when incorporated into human cancer cells. We research the dynamics, the charge transfer processes in semiconductor molecular interfaces, and we research novel thin film materials for detection and sensing.
Besides developing bottom-up and top-down strategies to generate new materials and build light-responsive interfaces, we are interested in the dynamics of the light-driven processes and the mechanistic details underlying a targeted function. And the knowledge we collect by investigating these mechanisms, we use to form relationships between structure, dynamics, and function, which can help us to improve the properties of the material.
Such investigations on the interplay between molecular structure, photo-induced dynamics, and the actual function of the molecular system is also key to an emerging research field, is key to artificial photosynthesis. In artificial photosynthesis, researchers try to mimic the natural paradigm of photosynthesis in that systems are designed which do absorb light and use the light of the energy of the absorbed light to convert it into chemical fuels, for instance, into hydrogen. Within our collaborative research center, Catalyte, a multidisciplinary team of researchers from Jena, Ulm, Mainz, and Vienna actually researches such questions. In integrating photocatalysts into hierarchically structured soft matter to devise materials, to devise novel approaches for material-integrated photocatalyst to generate hydrogen as a renewable clean fuel for the future.
So to be able to make a photocatalyst more efficient and more stable, we need exactly to know how the photocatalyst works. And here we are especially interested in the charge transfer processes from the excited light harvesting center to the actual reaction site, where, for example, the hydrogen evolution from water occurs. And these charge transfer processes are usually very, very fast and occur in the picosecond time domain. And to follow such fast processes, we use pump probe spectroscopic techniques, observing changes in the absorbance of the sample upon formation of excited states and the charge separation process.
A particular challenge in the field of artificial photosynthesis is given by the fact that we are dealing with reactions which involve multiple electrons. In that sense, light absorption and subsequent electron transfer within the molecular or supramolecular system leads to an intermediate state which then again has to absorb light for a second electron transfer to occur and actually charge the catalyst so it can take action. Therefore, we need to have experimental tools to study not only the first electron transfer, which can be done by routine pump probe spectroscopy, but actually also the second electron transfer. In order to do so, to have access to the function-determining excited state relaxation processes in these intermediates, we combine ultrafast time-resolved spectroscopy with electrochemistry. Thereby, we mimic these intermediates electrochemically and then study the photophysics of their excited states. Another challenge that emerges from material integration of molecular catalysts is to characterize the surface of these materials in terms of chemical composition, in terms of reactivity, in terms of degradation and aging over time. In order to tackle this problem, we resort to vibrational sub-frequency generation, a methodology that allows us to observe IR absorption-like spectra from the interface between the material and the aqueous phase, the catalyst, is operating in.
For our experiments, we use femtosecond laser pulses with tunable wavelengths throughout the whole visible range, depending on the absorption properties of our sample under investigation. And for probing, we need broadband laser pulses in the visible range or the mid-IR range. To generate these pulses, we use titanium sapphire amplifier systems to pump optical parametric amplifiers to be able to shift the wavelengths as necessary throughout the visible range, even into the mid-IR. Or we use this femtosecond output of the titanium sapphire systems to generate a white light continuum.
My name is Heiner, and I'm working on the vibrational sum frequency generation setup. For my research, I need a strong and reliable amplifier system so I can purely focus on my experiments.